frá atgervi Óðins. Þó Ósa Óðin kom og Norðurlönd og með honum dýjar það sagt með sann yndum að þær hófu og kendu íðróttir þar menn hafa lengi síðan medfarit. Óðin var göfgastur af öllum og af honum nómu þær allir íðróttirnar því að hann kunni fyrst allar og þó flestar. En það að segja, fyrir verja sök hann var svo mjög tígnaður, þó boru þessir lutir til. Hann var svo fagir og göfuglígir ólítum, þó hann satt með vínum sinum, að öllum hló hugur við. En þó hann var í her, þó syndist hann grimligir sínum óvinum. En það bar til þess að hann kunni þær ídrottir að hann skipti lítum og líkjum og verja lund. Ynglingasaga, chapter 6 of Odin's Deeds. When Ósa Odin came to the northern land, and with him the deer, they practiced and taught such sports that people have been practicing and teaching for a long time after. Odin was the greatest of them all, and it was from him that they all learned these sports, for he knew them first, or at least most of them. Now it shall be said why it was that he was so highly honored. It was for these reasons. He was so beautiful and dignified to look at when he sat among his friends, that everybody present had to feel joy in their souls. But when he was out in the army, he appeared grim and dangerous to his enemies. And this was because he knew those sports, that he could change color and appearance in every way after his own desire. Another was that he could speak so well and so eloquently that anyone who listened thought it must be the only truth. He spoke all his speeches in poetical verses, just like we today recite what is called skaldskap, poetic creation. He and his temple priests were called songsmiths, since they brought this sport into the northern lands. Odin could do this, that in battle his enemies became blind or deaf or struck with fear, and their weapons did not bite more than sticks, while his own men went without armor and were crazy like dogs or wolves. They bit into their shields. They were strong like bears or young oxen. They killed the man-people, and neither fire nor iron could harm them. This is called going berserk.
Kallaðir berserksgangur.
Odin kunni þó ídrott, mestur måttur fylgdi, og framdi sjálfur, seiðr heitir. En af tví måtti hann vita örlög manna og uordna luti, svo og at gera mönnum bana, eða uhamingju, eða vanheilindi, svo og at taka frå mönnum vit eða affl og gefa ödrum. En þessi Fjǫlkyngi frami der, fylgir svo mikil ergi, at eigi þotti karlmönnum skamlaust vid at fara, og var gydjunum kend su idrott. Odin knew that sport with which the greatest power followed, and practiced it himself, what is called Seiðr. And from this, he could know the fates of men and things not yet happened. And he could give men their bane or misfortune and bad health. And also, he could take from men wit or strength and give to others. And to this Fjǫlkyngi, as it is practiced, so much ergi follows that menfolk could not practice it without shame, and it came to the priestesses to know this sport. Ynglinga Saga 7.
Och när nu solen inte kvider igen, att då fjäll.